It's that time of year when you and your pet can enjoy an afternoon of Easter bone hunting. Lynn Robinson and Carrie Collins Mooney, along with Dudley, with his pretty green paws for people's scarf
Absolutely.
On, are here now to tell us all about the Easter bone hunt. Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing good. We like Dudley. He's nice.
Isn't he sweet?
Sitting there. He's cute.
He's very well behaved.
Wow. So, paws for people, Easter bone hunt. And Lynn, I was just telling you, I do think the pictures were funny, cute. I mean, that rabbit with that dog was pretty funny. I love that picture. Did you send me that picture,
Karen?
Yes,
I did.
I love that picture. That was good.
The rabbit is bigger than the dog.
Yeah. Well, and the dog just looked like he was just like, yeah, I'm posing for my Easter picture. But it was cute. You know what I mean? So yeah. I like that. You know, I thought it was really a great way for people to get out, meet other people, your pets play and all that stuff. That's always a great
thing. It's fun. It is really a lot of fun. And people from all over just come, bring their dogs, have fun, and eat, and hunt, and enjoy each other, which is really neat.
Yeah, it's a great time. Yes, it's a great time. It's on Saturday, April 12th this year at the Blue Hen Bed and Breakfast right on Nottingham Road in Newark. And we'll be starting gathering around 1 p.m., and then the hunt will actually begin at 1:30. And refreshments and activities will be starting around 2. I actually brought you a flyer.
Yay! Okay, an Easter bone, and he's got a pile of bones.
Yes. It's a great time. So many treats, toys, games for dogs, and there are activities for children as well. It's a great time for the whole family.
Paws for people, I think people need to know, like, this isn't just about having a good time, but you guys actually have made a real impact in the community, whether it's with kids, whether it's through, you know, kids reading, pet therapy. This is an organization that is really growing, and you do so many good things.
Love that you talk that way. Thank you.
You do.
Well, the whole basis is for people like Carrie and Dudley to go visit folks that are sad or lonely or feeling uncomfortable or in physical and occupational therapy. I mean, we have 23 different programs to work with. But in order to support that, we need to do events like the Easter Bone Hunt and other things throughout the year. I did want to give you this. This is our Paws calendar, and here's a picture of Dudley.
So this is my calendar.
That is your calendar.
Oh, look at this calendar. This is cute.
And a couple other friends that you have met in the past are in there too. So
really, you always bring good friends. Yes, they're all memorable.
Sunny's in there. And
wow.
That's it, yeah.
What do you want people to know most about what Paws does in the community? Because you got new programs that you're working on too now.
Yes. I would think if people could understand that what we do is use the connection, the beautiful connection between people and animals, which is a positive healing connection. And we use that to help people feel better. And so again, whether it's somebody in hospice waiting to die, or it's a 6-month-old at AI DuPont Hospital with some kind of issue, or it's just somebody that's lonely, we work with them and do a whole lot of things. Now, having mentioned new programs, I brought this because I wanted you to know about this. This is a brand new program that we've just started. It's called What Do You Do With the Dog at Home? So we have 370 trained therapy teams, Carrie, Dudley, team, you and your pussycat, maybe a team. We have those folks that are out doing the reading programs, the work with the autism, the work with drug and alcohol rehab, all of those programs. But we've decided that it would also be important to help parents understand that their family dog can be a therapy dog for their special needs children.
Really?
So we've developed this program, and we're actually teaching parents how to work with their family dog who might be sitting over there while their child is having a meltdown. How about we bring the dog over and support the child like we would do?
Right.
Because that's the work that we do, but we're trying to explain to parents that they can incorporate their animals to encourage the child to get up and get more physical activity, or to relax and be calming and pet the dog and brush the dog while they're doing their homework, or just to be able to speak more. I'm working with a little boy who's 5. He's nonverbal, high on the autism spectrum, and he talks to the dog.
Really?
But if I say, okay, tell Dudley to sit, he'll say, sit. We can't hear that. Dudley can't hear that. They'll say, sit louder, and his mom's going, oh, he's talking.
Right.
But he'll do it for the dog, which is a really neat, that again, that's the connection. People feel more comfortable doing that. So we can use lots and lots of techniques that we do because we're trained to, but we can help the parents understand that too. Yeah, pretty neat, huh?
Right, and I think it's amazing how you guys always find great teams, Karen and Dudley. I mean, because this is a commitment. This is, you know, it's something that you want to do,
yeah.
You know, and Why did you decide to be part of Pause for People?
Pause for People is a great organization that provided us with training so that we could be more effective. Dudley had a natural ability I saw in our own lives to be comforting and therapeutic and help people relax. And Pause for People was a great organization to help us get started and think about what we would do in different situations we hadn't thought about before, like if someone was non-responsive, how we could still visit with them, or if someone was afraid of dogs and how we could visit with them as well and have a great time.
Wow, that is amazing. And you guys have a lot of great teams.
I met a lot of teams.
I mean, I just think that this is amazing how the organization keeps going in different directions.
Well, I think we're very blessed with the folks, because the people that come to us to be trained love their animals, so that's special. And they love people enough to be wanting to spend their extra time to make that connection. So while we have everything from judges and billionaires to kids that are just working and wanting community hours and they work with their own animals, they come. But one thing that you did mention is Pause, I believe, we try very hard